Right, gamers, good luck and welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Kenny Gamer here, and today it's the start of our Arsenal FIFA 22 career mode. So as you can see, there's no camera, just for reasons. But yeah, let's just get started with Arsenal career mode. So we're gonna play on professional just to, you know, get the hang of things. We won't be in any competitions, and there's also not gonna be a transfer window for the first summer. Yeah, let's go. Probably gonna have to turn the music off because of copyright reasons. Took a 2-week break because I just didn't know what to do until, yeah, right, hang on, let's just delete these quickly, that and that. Alright, so there we go.
A warm welcome to you all. Without further delay, we are pleased to introduce your new manager.
Yeah. So, what's our objectives? Sign 4 players in the youth academy assigned to each of the following positions: goalkeeper, defender, midfielder and forward. Within 2 seasons, sign 1 youth player to the senior team, play them in 10 matches, either as a part of the starting 11 or coming on as a sub. Gain 129 mil earning from shirt sales within a season. Get 7 wins or at least 1 goal scored in away matches this season. Replace 3 players from the team. Finishing UEFA Europa League spot, win the FA Cup within 2 seasons in the Premier League, finishing a Europa Champions League place. Not hard, but not easy. Objectives, that was it. Oh, I couldn't speak. Change formation to 4-3-2-1 because I think it'll just be way better. I don't know what White's doing there. We'll bring on Xhaka and then Holding on the bench. So we're gonna have to change a couple of positions on the players. So like, I want Xhaka and Smith Rowe to be left wing and right wings, and obviously Xhaka to the centre mid, and Maitland-Niles to a cam, and probably sort out a couple of contracts on the players as well, get through all the training, and then probably even play our first game of the season against Brentford, which Arsenal lost in real life, which is pretty sad. So I know this is a little bit late, because, you know, it's like close to halfway through the season. I know it's pretty late, but yeah. Xhaka centre mid will take 29 weeks, and Smith Rowe to left wing, and left wing, and Saka to a right wing. That's what I want. That'll take 2 weeks. Alright, I need Saka. Saka. And Saka to a right wing. That will also take 2 weeks. Okay, that is it for now. I want to do our second team, because we've got a lot of amazing and promising youngsters like Charlie Patino, Eddie Nketiah, Maitland Niles, Sammy Lukonga, obviously, and yeah, so we want to put Martinelli on, Nketiah, Pepe, that's not the one I want. Alright, you there, Lukonga, and just put Patino on here, and also put Xhaka on the bench. Put Tavares, Holding, and Ben White, and Tomiyasu in midfield. Defence. So that's going to be our second team. I think it's a pretty solid second team, to be fair. And obviously a solid first team. So yeah, we'll go with that. And now we got to go through all of the training drills. I know on FIFA 22 there's this new thing where you can actually simulate your drills without play, like without, like, it just skips it basically. But like, I don't really want to do that, but I might eventually. Oh my god, I can't believe I dismissed that. So yeah, I'm actually just probably gonna do that thing. Cause like, I just don't wanna go through all the training, so probably after these three drills, just use that bypass thing. But after like 20 days, I'm gonna like use the second team for some drills, or like the first 10 days. And then after the 10 days, just the second team, and then like, you know. Next drill. I am gonna stream some Fortnite tomorrow, maybe, or maybe later if I actually feel like it. So if we do the bypass thing for the training drills, we are gonna play possibly the first two games, probably even three games of the season, which is, we have got Brentford, Chelsea, and Manchester City. And I do also want to shortlist a couple of players that I will be signing in the future. There is one player that I am signing in January. But there's no transfer windows for the first summer transfer window. There's no transfers. There's like no one being bought in or players being sold from each and every club. So this is not going to plan at the moment, this drill. It's one of my like least favourite drills in the game. With also the interceptor drills are quite alright now. It's been fixed, but the merry-go-round has not been fixed. That's the one EA was saying that they were going to fix in FIFA 22, but it's just got worse. It really has got worse. Oh my god. And now we just do that. Alright, you know what? I'm just gonna do this. And then, yeah. For the first 10 days, we stop. Oh, we didn't answer his... Oh, well, don't really matter. Didn't answer the captain's email. But who cares? Alright, now for the next day, 10 days. There we go. We got Smith Rose thing and Saka's position change, so then I can just switch over to Saka. There we go. Done. Alright, then now for the next 10 days, we might do a little bit more. Whatever. Okay, now we've got a couple of more. We got the youth setup. We got not as good players. The Knowles is now turning into a Cam. So, I mean, this is just so much faster, which is pretty decent. A lot of players are not going to be as sharp, but I will work on that. It'll get fixed eventually. I guess we'll do the last training drill for the first team. Okay. So, how's the team looking? Some players are sharp, some of them aren't sharp. Do you want to work on some of the player contracts quickly? So, like, if I just go down to Charlie Patino, I think he's on 11 months. Yep, I'm definitely gonna do the contract negotiations. So I'm gonna do a rotation. Okay. Give him an extra 4 years. See what it, yep, he'll accept that. No release clause, and I'm gonna give him a 7.5 contract. And he does accept it, which is nice. There's Eddie Nketiah and Lacazette I need to do now. Alright, so Spradic, I'll give him a Spradic. 3 years, yep. No release clause, and I'll give him a 50 and I'll give him a 100k signing bonus. And Lacazette, which I'm not gonna pay as much for his wage. I might bring it down to about 90, 85. I'll probably bring it down to 85, you know. Yeah, that'll do. Yep. And now I'm gonna go up to 90 just in case he doesn't accept it, and I'll do a 200k signing bonus. There we go. Right, is that done? Now time for the press conference.
Thank you guys, thank you for joining us. We'll take questions now.
Europa League is the target, but hoping to get Champions League next season. Don't know why they got on about transfers.
Okay, guys.
Oh yeah, I forgot I was gonna say that I was gonna shortlist some players. So this is a striker for when we sell Aubameyang. Youssef N'Ziri, very good player. Also this right wing, I'm thinking for when we possibly sell Pepe, because he is 26, he is getting a little bit old. And free centre, this is the player I'm looking at to sign in January, Yves Bissouma. And possibly even Ruben Neves. Where is he? Did I go past him? No. Where is he? Ruben Neves, there we go. Ruben Neves and two more centre mids, probably with Zakaria is good. Yeah, probably. Probably sign Zakaria. I'm probably Camavinga. So that's the shortlist. It's a pretty decent shortlist. Stats, Ruben Neves, pretty decent. This needs work on his athleticism, speed, jumping. Yeah, just a little bit. Right, anyway, let's get to this game against Brentford. Think we'll go with that team. See if we can get our first win of the season. So the Brentford Stadium isn't in the game, obviously. Don't know when it's going to be added. It should be added soon. Jonathan David. Might do. Yeah, probably. Jonathan David or N'Ziri probably is going to be our striker option for Aubameyang soon.
Hello, good evening.
Oh, turning the commentary off, definitely. Don't need the commentary on. Audio commentary down, so yeah, no, I'm gonna do that. Yeah, probably as well. I haven't heard of him, but might. There's a pass. Oh my god, don't. What? I got. Jesus. Get there. Messi. Nice. I might even sign Vlahovic maybe as well, because it's been rumours in real life that he's probably going to go to Arsenal. Oh, and the attack with Saka. Cross it in. No. Yes, Gabrielle. Don't know what happened there. Jacko. Yes, it was. Oh, what good save rounds though. Oh my god, Sack. Go off the side, I think. Didn't know what happened there, probably offside. Nice way, I guess. No, yes, Ramsdale. Really, Ramsdale? Yes, so do God. Smith Rowe, man, come on. Yes, Gabrielle. Partey, oh my god, Partey. Crap shot. It's literally our first shot on target. Like, no, not on target, it's our first, like, shot. Brentford have had multiple shots. Alright, half time, 0-0. Not the greatest start. Yeah, they've had more possession. We've had one shot. Yeah. They've been dominating. Don't think I need to make any subs at half time, but I probably will. Like, I don't know, probably. No, I don't think anyone. Yeah, probably not. Yeah, no one. Second half. Saka. Should have passed it. Should have passed it. Oh no, I thought I won the ball. Jesus. Gabriel again. Jesus. Oh my god. That's why. That's Laka. Oh, look at it. Jesus. Oh, I was meant to go to Laka, but it almost works. Right, I think a sub needs to be made. I think Saka needs to come off for Pepe to just get some fresh legs on, see if we can hopefully win this game. Yes, Xhaka. Pepe. Crosses it into Laka. Partey. Oh yes, Tomiyasu. Tomiyasu's still got it. Why am I passing it? What are my players doing? Laka, the Smith Rowe, just literally was on each other. Like, just look at this. Look, I'll show you the replay. Just. Like, look. What is happening over here? I don't want to look at the ball. Just look at. Look at Laka and Smith Rowe. Just what is that? Oh, Pepe, man. Thank God, yes. Oh my god, Tomiyasu is, it's not the best right back to use, especially for an Arsenal team, especially for the team like Arsenal. That is not a free kick, ref. Won't take Laka off, we'll take off. Yep. And Maitland Niles just to bring on two fresh legs. Because we need it. He's going to have a little. He's going to have a shot. Over. Tavares. Okay. What a luck is it? You telling me I'm actually gonna draw this game? Cause like, oh, Partey man, what are you doing? Oh god, make the noise. Well, come on, please. Yes, my Maitland-Niles. Come on. Come on. It's a decent free will from Lacazette to Maitland-Niles. And Maitland-Niles might have just won it for us. Oh god, yeah, they're... Right, nice Xhaka. Not nice Xhaka, oh my god, no. Beat out. But, yes! First win of the season, Maitland-Niles with the goal, 88th minute, Lacazette with the assist. Second half, we weren't, I mean, if we just took the match stats, yeah, like Brentford with this dominating possession, literally the entire game, like the first half. Yeah, they were just dominating possession and shooting. They had 9 shots. 2 on target, 3 off target, and 4 blocked. And passing stats. Yeah, that would just, Brentford were just a better team, to be honest. But we still somehow got the win. It was all 100% effort. Nice, no, that's gonna stand everything else. Right, I'm going to end it here. Decent first episode of this. Let me know any signings. Because, I mean, there is a couple, like Jonathan David, Zachariah, obviously. But I will be adding to this. But, like, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. And see you guys probably tomorrow. I might be recording a video, not streaming a video soon. Like, cause, yeah. Right, see you guys in a bit.